I know India as the world's biggest democracy. But in these past few days, I've been receiving a huge, huge amount of messages from people of India. They write to me, please help us, our internet is being shut down, the people are dying and the world doesn't know about it. If one thing is true is that I didn't hear anything anywhere, so at first I just ignored these messages. But then message after message after message, I couldn't ignore it anymore. Why people in India feel like they are not being heard? So I did my research and I am in shock. Only this year, India shut down the internet 91 times in different parts of the country. Last year, 134 times. In fact, 67% of world's reported internet shutdowns happened in India. Turns out, the world's biggest democracy regularly limits people's voices. And in all of this, Indian economy suffered a loss of $3 billion just in the past few years. That is a lot of money. But even if all these shutdowns cost people money, what is most important is the price of freedom being taken away from the people. Dear customer, as per the government instructions, the internet services have been temporarily stopped in your area. That was a text message people woke up to in the areas affected by the protests. This is a text message that no democratic government should ever send. And this isn't just about India, it's about every country. We all should strive to live in a more democratic, beautiful world that doesn't limit its people's voices. So as someone lucky enough to have a voice, I want to share with you some of the messages that I've gotten in the past few days from the voices that cannot be heard. Adula says, our unity in diversity is getting disturbed and scattered every day. Sophia says we are protesting to save our culture, language and our land. Grace says please let everyone know what is happening in Northeast India. And finally Hassan says India passed a new law that offers faster citizenship to non-Muslim people from certain places. People say the bill is unfair to Muslims. I don't know who's right and who's wrong, but what I know is that these are the voices that have a right to be heard. As you can hear, this is a very complicated issue, but at least now you know and you can do your own research and make your own decisions. Me, myself, I didn't really want to take any sides in all of this, but I have to. I stand on the side of democracy. Because in every democratic country, human voice should be the human right. And right now in India, there are people who really need to be heard, but their voices have been taken away from them.